with the anticipation. If you're worried about the damage cicadas can do to trees and shrubs, there are some ways you can protect your landscape.
WGN's Andrea Medina is at the Morton Arboretum with details.
If you have young trees like this one, shrubs, or even special trees, experts recommend using light, airy materials like tulle to wrap around the whole branching area to keep cicadas away. The Morton Arboretum is a registered tree museum specializing in rare and endangered plants. Knowing their vulnerability, horticulturists are protecting them and recently planted trees like this crabapple before a swarm of cicadas start to invade the Chicago region.
You can use any type of material that is kind of light and airy. So there is bird netting, there's other insect netting and tulle.
Tree experts say using the correct type of fabric to tightly net the branching area is crucial.
So you're looking for netting that's no bigger than a quarter inch across, because any bigger than that, the cicadas can climb through and defeats the whole purpose of protecting them. That size also lets moisture in and out. It allows sunlight to penetrate.
Once the soil reaches 64 degrees, cicadas will dig themselves out from the ground. They grow, mate, and then the females make slits in the branches to lay their eggs. Most mature, healthy trees can handle this without any long-term damage, but not young ones or shrubs.
That mechanical injury can kill small trees or small branches and twigs.
In Illinois, there are annual cicadas in the summer.
They cause no lasting impacts on the trees in our community, so we do not recommend any protection for the annual cicadas.
But there will be a historic emergence this spring with two broods of periodical cicadas coming out at the same time. In central and southern Illinois, it's a 13-year cicadas. And in central and northern Illinois, it's a 17-year cicadas.
You have to remember that they are native insects. They are part of our natural ecosystem. And through their activities in the soil, they are digging and they're burrowing, so they're aerating the soil. They're contributing to our soil health and microbiome.
While these insects are loud with their buzzing noises and creepy looking with their beady blood-red eyes, they're harmless. There's no exact date of when they will appear, but there have been sightings.
We found the first signs of periodical cicada emergence about a week and a half ago, so they are emerging. So we're expecting the kind of the mass emergence to probably be in another week or two.
As we expect millions, possibly billions of cicadas to emerge from the ground, they'll only stick around for about 4 to 6 weeks. Reporting at the Morton Arboretum, Andrea Medina, WGN News.